further refine our descent methods, let's go back to this picture. We're at some iteration where we have computed xk, and now we want to find some search direction. Now, intuitively, you might think to yourself, gee, I would like to go in the direction where I go down the slope the steepest, because surely then I will decrease the value of f of x most rapidly, and therefore surely that must be a really good direction to go into. Well, that direction actually has a name. It's called the steepest descent direction. So if we do that, we end up with something known as the method of steepest descent. Okay, well, if you have a general function f of x, then the gradient of that function at that value x is actually the direction of steepest ascent, the direction in which you increase most rapidly, and therefore it is minus that that is actually the direction of steepest descent. Now, in our case, our function x had a very special form. It was 1/2 x transpose ax minus x transpose b. Okay, and we reasoned in the opener for this week that its gradient was given by ax minus b, and therefore taking the negative of the gradient gives you the negative of this, and that is just equal to b minus ax, which is the residual if you think of x as the current approximation to the solution. And notice that that residual is happily available every time in our iteration. What does that mean? Well, it means that we could try thinking our next direction to be simply our current residual. And that's known as the method of steepest descent.